Hello students, today we are going to see the problems from trigonometry. So this problem related to the CBSE previous year sample paper questions. So here we are going to use the trigonometric table value as well as the trigonometric identity to find the value of the given expression as well as the proving part of the problem, where I have to use the trigonometric identity to prove the LHS expansion, which is equal to the right hand side value. Coming to the session, we are going to see the problems in chapter 8 trigonometry, where this problems has been taken from the CBSE previous year questions. The first problem: in triangle ABC, angle B is 90 degree, BC is 5 cm, AB is given as 4 cm. We need to find the value for sin A, cos A and secant A. So he was talking to you about the right angle triangle. So let me draw the right angle triangle ABC with the B is equal to 90 and BC given as 5 cm, AB measure as 4 cm. So here he needs to find sin A, cos A and secant A. We know that the trigonometric ratio for all these three cases will be sin A will be opposite side to angle A by hypotenuse, cos A adjacent side to angle A by hypotenuse, and secant A which is nothing but the reciprocal of cos A. So for all these ratios we need the hypotenuse. So since it is a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse can be found out by using Pythagoras theorem. Now coming to the solution: in triangle ABC, we know that angle B is equal to 90 degree, so AC is the hypotenuse. Now in order to find out the hypotenuse length, we use the Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we know that the sum of the other two side square will be equivalent to the hypotenuse square. So here, depending upon this, we are writing hypotenuse AC square, which is equal to the other two side square. So AB square plus BC square. Here we know that angle B is 90 and the other two angles, angle A and angle C, are acute angles. So depending upon these two acute angles, the opposite side and the adjacent side may differ. If I take angle C, the side opposite to angle C will be AB. So AB is taken as opposite side. If I take my acute angle as A, my opposite side will be BC. So depending upon both the acute angles, your opposite side and the adjacent side may vary. Now I am using here AC square is equal to the sum of the other two side square. So where AB square is equal to 4 square plus BC square 5 square. So which is equal to 16 plus 25, which is 41. So my hypotenuse AC is equal to square root of 41. So hence I find the hypotenuse as root of 41. Now I need to find out the value for sin A. So my sin A trigonometric ratio, which is nothing but opposite side to angle A by hypotenuse. See, the hypotenuse remains same whichever acute angles you take, either your A or C. Now the side opposite to angle A will be BC. So BC by hypotenuse is AC, where BC is given as 5 cm and hypotenuse is root 41. Now similarly, cos A is equal to adjacent side to angle A by hypotenuse. So where adjacent side to angle A will be AB. So I am writing AB by hypotenuse is AC, which is equal to 4 by root 41. Similarly, the third one, I need to find out the secant A. Secant A, you studied that it is a reciprocal of cos A, where cos A we have taken it as cos A as 4 by root 41. So secant A will be root 41 by 4. Second problem: if cos of A plus B is equal to 0 and cot of A minus B is equal to root 3, find the value of secant A into tan B minus cot A into sin B. So here, coming to the solution, I am writing this first case: cos of A plus B is equal to 0. So I am looking to the trigonometric table for what value of cos I will be getting the value as 0. So from the trigonometric table, I got that
cos of 90 degree, which is equal to 0. So now comparing these two cases, my right hand side both values are 0. So my left hand side will be equivalent. So where a plus b will be equivalent to 90. So when I comparing these two cases, I got a plus b, which is equal to 90 degree, calling this as equation 1. Now the next case, second one, it is given that cot of a minus b is equal to root 3. So where we know that tan 30 is equal to 1 by root 3, cot, which is a reciprocal of tan. So I can say that from trigonometric table, cot 30 is equal to root 3. Now comparing these two cases, I will be getting the equation a minus b is equal to 30 degree, calling this as equation 2. Now I am going to solving 1 and 2. So my equation 1, a plus b, which is equal to 90. Equation 2, a minus b, which is equal to 30 degree. Now plus b minus b gets cancelled. 2a is equal to 120, which implies a is equal to 120 divided by 2, 60 degree. Now I am going to substitute the value of a in equation 1, where equation 1, a plus b is equal to 90, where a is equal to 60 plus b, which is equal to 90, which implies b is equal to 90 minus of 60, which is equal to 30 degree. So I get a value as 60, b value as 30. Now I want to see in this problem, find the value of secant a into tan b minus cot a into sin b. So now I am going to take the problem secant a, find the value for secant a into tan b minus of cot a into sin b. First I will substitute the value of a and b here. I will be getting secant 60 into b tan 30 minus of cot 60 into sin 30. So from the trigonometric table, I am going to use the values here. So where secant 60 will be 2 into tan 30 value is 1 by root 3 minus of cot 60. So cot 60, tan 60. So tan 60 will be root 3. Cot 60 will be 1 by root 3 into sin 30. Sin 30 value is half. Now multiplying, I will be getting 2 by root 3 minus of 1 by 2 root 3. Now further taking LCM, I will be getting the LCM of 2 root 3. So multiplying 2, I will get 4 minus of here I will have 1. So which is equal to 3 by 2 root 3. Since your 3 has 2 root 3, root 3 into root 3 becomes 3. So I am writing this as root 3 into root 3. So root 3 gets cancelled. So one more root 3 will be there in the numerator and 2 is in the denominator. I will be getting root 3 by 2. Hence I got this value as root 3 by 2. Third problem, if sin theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, find the value of cos power 12 theta, 3 cos power 10 theta plus 3 cos power 8 theta plus cos power 6 theta plus 2 cos power 4 theta plus 2 cos power 2 theta minus of 2. So here I am going to use the given thing in the problem in order to find out the answer for the given ratios. Okay, so the first one I am taking sin theta plus sin squared theta is equal to 1. So here since it deals with power 2, I am going to use the trigonometric identities here. So where sin theta keeping on my left side, taking the sin squared to the right side, it becomes 1 minus of sin squared theta, so which is equal to cos square theta. So this sin theta, which is equivalent to cos square theta. Now in place of sin theta here, I am going to replace my cos square theta, or if any cos square theta, I can replace the sin theta. So either way I can use it. So now coming to the solution, I am writing cos power 12 theta plus 3 cos power 10 theta plus 3 cos power 8 theta plus cos power 6 theta plus 2 cos power 4 theta plus 2 cos power 2 theta minus of 2. So in this case, it deals with cos power 12 theta and the cos power 10, 8, 6. I'm grouping this together as single case. So we see the word 3, number 3 here. So it remembers me that the formula x plus y the whole cube. In x plus y the whole cube expansion, I have the middle term 3a squared b, 3ab squared. So in place of, see, since I have 3 here, I will just try whether this x plus y the whole cube is possible here. So where I am writing cos 12 as 4 into 3. So I am keeping 4 inside theta plus the last case because of x cube plus y cube. The x cube is the first term and y cube is the last term. In between I have 3x squared y plus 3xy squared. So here the last term I am just writing this as cos power 2 theta, that is 6. I am taking it as 2 into 3. So 2 I am writing inside. So the remaining I am writing it as 2 cos power 10 plus 3 cos power 8 theta. So here I am writing this as power 3 and this as power 3. So this is of the form x cube plus 3 x squared y plus 3 x y squared plus y power 3. So this remembers the formula cos to the power of 4 theta plus cos square theta the whole power cube. So I have cos power 4, that is x cube. So x, y cube, y. So x plus y the whole cube will give you the expansion as cos power 4 theta the whole cube and so on. So the next case, I am just taking this 2 commonly outside. I will be having cos power 4 theta plus cos square theta minus of 1. So now I am taking this 2 commonly outside. Now taking this cos power 4 theta and I have plus cos squared theta minus 1. Now I am going to substitute where the sine is equal to cos squared theta, where we found out in the first case here, where cos square theta is sine. So cos power 4 theta will be sine square theta. Square cos square theta is sine. So cos power 4 theta will become sine square theta. Writing this as cos square theta plus 2. Now cos power 4. Cos power 4, as I said, it becomes sine square theta plus cos square theta minus of 1. So where now sine square theta plus cos square theta, you will be knowing the identity, valid trigonometric identity, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 plus 2 into sine square plus cos square becomes 1, 1 minus of 1. So where you have 1 plus 2 into 0, this becomes 0. So 1 plus 0, which is equal to 1. So I got this value, which will be equivalent to 1 as the answer. Fourth problem, if 8x is equal to cosecant A and 8 by x is equal to cot A, find the value of 4 into x squared minus of 1 by x squared. So here I am going to find out the value for x in this expression, and I am going to, that is your x and 1 by x from this 2, I am going to substitute here. So where, coming to the solution, I have 8x is equal to cosecant A, where x is equal to cosecant A, this 8 comes under division. So similarly, the next case, 8 by x is equal to cot A. So where I have 1 by x is equal to 8 comes to the denominator, cot A by 8. Now I am going to substitute the value of x and the value of 1 by x in my expression. So 4 into x squared minus of 1 by x squared. So here I am writing this as 4 into x square minus of 1 by x the whole square. So I am writing this 1 by x squared as 1 by x the whole square. So now 4 into x value is cosecant A by 8. So x squared becomes cosecant squared a by 8 squared becomes 64 minus of 1 by x is cot a by 8. So the whole square becomes cot square a by 8 square is 64. So which is equal to, so I am going to take the 64 in the denominator which is common. So I am taking this 64 outside. I will be getting 1 by 64 as common. So you have already 4. So I am taking 1 by 64 outside. The remaining inside the bracket will be cosecant squared a minus cot squared a. So from the trigonometric identity, you will be knowing that cosecant squared a minus of cot squared a value is 1. So I will be getting 4 into 1 by 64 into 1. So which becomes 4 will go 16 times. So the value is 1 by 16. So I got 4 into x squared minus 1 by x squared. The value is 1 by 16. Fifth problem, prove that 1 plus cos a by sin a plus sin a by 1 plus cos a is equal to 2 cosecant a. Here I want to prove my LHS which is equivalent to the RHS. So I am going to take my LHS and derive in order to bring into 2 cosecant a. So here my coming to the solution, my LHS will be 1 plus cos a by sin a plus sin a by 1 plus cos a. Now since this 2 is of a fractions, so where the denominators are different, I am going to take the LCM. So where LCM is sin a into 1 plus cos a, where both the denominators are taken as a LCM. Since I have sin a here, 1 plus cos a is missing. So I want to multiply 1 plus cos a with both the cases. So here numerator 1 plus cos a into 1 plus cos a, I will be getting 1 plus cos a the whole squared. Plus here I have 1 plus cos a, sin a is not there. So it gets multiplied with the numerator, sin a into sin a, it becomes sin squared a. Now further I am going to expand. This is of the form a plus b the whole squared. So where a plus b the whole squared is a squared plus 2ab, so 2 cos a plus b squared will be cos squared a. Again you have sin squared a here, so sin squared a divided by sin a into 1 plus cos a. Now we know that from the trigonometric identity, sin squared plus cos squared is equal to 1. So we have 1 already, 1 square is 1 plus 2 cos a plus sin squared plus cos squared, the value is 1 using the identity, trigonometric identity, and sin a into 1 plus cos a. So where I have 1 plus 1 which is 2 plus 2 cos a by sin a into 1 plus cos a. So here I am going to take this 2 commonly outside. I will be having, if I take 2 commonly outside, I will be having 1 plus cos a inside the bracket. So denominator sin a into 1 plus cos a. 1 plus cos a, 1 plus cos a gets cancelled. You will be having 2 by sin a, which is equal to 2 into 1 by sin a, where 1 by sin a, where the reciprocal of sin a will be cosecant a. So 2 into cosecant a. Hence I derive that LHS is equal to RHS. Sixth problem, prove that square root of 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta plus square root of 1 minus sin theta by 1 plus sin theta, which is equal to 2 secant theta. See here, I want to bring my right hand side and deriving in order to bring it as my 2 secant theta, which is my left right hand side. So taking my left hand side, I am going to derive now. So coming to the solution, so LHS square root of 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. So first let us find the conjugate of this term, then we will go for this expression. So here I have the first one, square root of 1 plus sin theta by 1 minus sin theta. So here I am going to take the conjugate for my denominator. So the conjugate is multiplying and dividing by 1 plus sin theta. Since it is minus sin theta, I am taking its conjugate as multiplying with the numerator and the denominator by 1 plus sin theta. So I am writing this in brackets. Now going for the second case, I have square root of 1 minus sin theta by 1 plus sin theta. Similarly, since my denominator is 1 plus sin theta, I am taking it as conjugate, just expanding this line. So I will be having its conjugate multiplying with the numerator and denominator, its conjugate. So its conjugate 1 plus sin theta, conjugate will be 1 minus sin theta divided by 1 minus sin theta. So here now just multiplying numerator with the numerator, denominator with the denominator, it is under your square root. So 1 plus sin theta into 1 plus sin theta, it becomes 1 plus sin theta the whole squared. Since both have plus sign, so you will have a plus b into a plus b the whole squared. By similarly a minus b into a plus b, you have the identity a squared minus b squared. So a squared minus of b squared, everything will be under your square root. So you will be having plus. Similarly, you have 1 plus sin theta into 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta the whole squared. So divided by similarly a plus b into a minus b, a squared minus of b squared. Now here I have the numerator 1 plus sin theta the whole squared. Similarly, I can use a trigonometric identity where you have 1 minus sin squared becomes cos squared, because you have sin squared theta plus cos squared theta is equal to 1, where cos squared theta will be equivalent to, taking the sin squared, I will be getting 1 minus sin squared. So I am going to substitute here now. So 1 minus sin squared, this becomes cos squared theta plus here 1 minus sin theta the whole squared by cos squared theta. So which is equal to, Now I am going to remove the square root. So when I remove the square root, it becomes 1 plus sin theta by cos square theta, where if I remove the square root, square will go off. I will be having 1 plus sin theta by cos square theta. When I remove power 2, that is square root, power 2 will go off. You will be having cos theta. So again, the next term, I will be having square root of, so square root when I remove the power 2, square root goes off. So I will be having 1 minus sin theta dividing by cos power 2 theta 2. So I will have cos theta. Now I am separating this as 1 plus sin theta and plus, since I have the denominator same, I can take it as a common term, where the numerator plus 1 minus of sin theta. Sin theta plus sin theta minus sin theta gets cancelled. I will be having 2 by cos theta. So where 2 by cos theta is 2 into 1 by cos theta. So 1 by cos theta is nothing but secant theta. So I got 2 secant theta. So hence I expressed my left hand side, which will be equivalent to 2 secant theta.
Hope you understood that the value of the trigonometric table, that is your sin 30, cos 30, tan 30, tan 60, cot 60, secant 60, where all these trigonometric ratio values from the table we have used in the problem in order to find out the value for the given expression. Also, we use the trigonometric identity sin squared theta plus cos squared theta, which becomes 1, and cosecant squared theta minus cot squared theta, which is equal to 1. Secant square theta minus tan square theta, which is equal to 1. All this three trigonometric ratio were used in the proving problems in order to prove that the left hand side expansion, which becomes the right hand side value.